Good evening. Welcome to My Soul and Stillness Waits, our 14th annual Advent Benefit Concert. This year, with musical highlights presented live on tape from St. Patrick's Church in Anchorage, Alaska. Our closing song was taped at a previous concert. This year, the proceeds from this concert benefit the programs of Catholic Social Services. Permission to reprint lyrics, podcast, and stream the music have been obtained from one license, with license A717186, all rights reserved. In the spirit of St. Nicholas, we gather this evening to reflect prayerfully on the season of Advent. Think of all the people in the world who are homeless, who have no extras, some who have nothing. Father Leo Walsh, pastor at St. Patrick's, will begin our program with a prayer.
Good evening, or whenever you're watching this concert, and thank you so much for joining us for this very special event. As we begin, if it doesn't begin with a prayer and end with a prayer, it hasn't got a prayer, so let us pray. Prepare our hearts, we pray, O Lord, by your divine power, so that at the coming of Christ, your Son, we may be found worthy of the banquet of eternal life, and merit to receive heavenly nourishment from his hand, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Thank you for joining us, and God bless you.
It's Advent, the every year liturgical season of waiting in joyful hope for the coming of Christ at Christmas. How can we celebrate this season of grace? Advent is really about making room in our lives for Jesus. It's about opening our hearts to celebrate more fully the birth of Christ in Bethlehem so long ago, and to anticipate his coming again in glory at the end of time. And usually, we light the candles on an Advent wreath and pray for hope, love, joy, and peace. This year, in a world darkened by fear and uncertainty, let us make room in our hearts for hope as we await the coming of Jesus Christ, the hope of the world. In a world torn by incivility and division, let us make room in our hearts for love as we wait for the one who is love incarnate, Jesus Christ, our Savior. In a world too often plagued by misery and despair, let us make room in our hearts for joy as we wait for the Lord whose coming the angels proclaimed as joy to the world. And in a world weary of violence and unrest, let us make room in our hearts for peace as we wait for the coming of Jesus, the Prince of Peace. Let us celebrate Advent by praying together for hearts that are open and eager for the hope, love, joy, and peace that only our Savior can give. We will be praying for you, and we ask that you pray for us and for each other as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of Christ.
symptoms of inner hope, peace, joy, and love. The hearts of a great many have already been exposed to this virus, and it is possible that people everywhere could come down with it in epidemic proportions. This could pose a serious threat to what has, up to now, been a fairly stable condition of conflict in the world. Some signs and symptoms of the Advent virus: a tendency to think and act spontaneously rather than on fears based on past experiences, an unmistakable ability to enjoy each moment, a loss of interest in judging other people, a loss of interest in interpreting the actions of others, a loss of interest in conflict, a loss of the ability to worry. This is a very serious symptom. Frequent, overwhelming episodes of appreciation. Contented feelings of connectedness with others and nature. Frequent attacks of smiling. An increasing tendency to let things happen rather than to make things happen. An increasing susceptibility to the love extended by others, as well as the uncontrollable urge to extend it.
Life is a constant Advent season. We are continually waiting to become, to discover, to complete, to fulfill. Hope, struggle, fear, expectation, and fulfillment are all part of our Advent experience. The world is not as just, not as loving, not as whole as we know it can and should be. But the coming of Christ and his presence among us, as one of us, gives us reason to live in hope that light will shatter the darkness, that we can be liberated from our fears and prejudices, that we are never alone or abandoned. May this Advent season be a time for bringing hope, transformation, and fulfillment into the Advent of our lives.
Walking in fear. celebration of Christ's birth in ancient Bethlehem, Christ is reborn in the Bethlehems in our homes and daily lives. Take time, slow down, be still, be awake to the divine mystery that looks so common and so ordinary, yet is wondrously present. Loving God, as we begin the season of Advent, help us to pause. Slow us down and invite us to see you in the everydayness of our lives. Your face in the eyes of those we meet, your hand at work in the day-to-day miracles we so often take for granted. You are the one for whom we watch, the one who comes with healing and blessing, and you are present already among us. With grateful hearts, we pray. Amen. You are the light that shines in the darkness. Christ, be our light. We watch for your coming with abiding attention.
This new morning seems so strange. Beautiful, but not the same. Last night the angel came to speak, and today there is new light within me. I admit that I am scared. Love that I found.
The days are coming, says the Lord, when I will fulfill the promise I made in the house of Israel and Judah. In those days, in that time, I will raise up for David a just shoot. He shall do what is right and just in the land. In those days, Judah shall be safe, and Jerusalem shall dwell secure. This is what they shall call her: the Lord our justice.
Cries out in the
Like children pining for Christmas morning, we know what it means to wait for what we desire. Whether it is the safe arrival of loved ones from afar or a recovery from cancer, we wait in prayer and patience, hope and trust. The mystic Angelus Sibelius says, "If in your heart you make a manger for his birth, then God will come again, become a child on earth." Good and gracious God, we thank you for the hope we have in Jesus. Be present to us as we wait for the fulfillment of your promises and for Christ to come again. Help us to pause today and every day to worship you, to hear your word, and to do your will by sharing that hope with one another. We ask in the name of the one born in Bethlehem. Amen. You are the light that shines in the darkness. Christ, be our light. We wait for your coming with graced patience.
Thank you. woman's eyes, hands, used to them since childhood. Then brightness flared, too huge for simple days, and hands clasped when the words lost their space. In that little town, my son, where they knew us together, you called me mother. But no one had eyes to see the astounding events as they took place day by day. Your life became the life of the poor in your wish to be with them through the work of your hands. I knew the light that lingered in ordinary things, like a spark sheltered under the skin of our days. The light was you. It did not come from me. And I had more of you in that luminous silence than I had of you as the fruit of my body, my blood.
Thank you. consist of St. Francis House, which is our food pantry. Our pantry provides a 2 to 3 day emergency supply of food for people experiencing food insecurity. Last year, we provided food to over 10,000 people in our community. Brother Francis Shelter is an emergency shelter for adults aged 18 and older. Last year, we provided 24,000 nights of stay to over 460 people, and we also served over 64,000 meals in our shelter. Claire House is a shelter for women with children and expectant mothers. Last year, we served 220 women and children, which amounted to over 12,000 nights of emergency shelter stay. Our latter programs consist of Homeless Family Services, which is a housing case management service. Our case managers help people who are experiencing homelessness get housed, find jobs, connect to benefits and resources within our community. Last year, we housed 304 households, which represented over 542 individuals. FDS, or Family Disability Services, is a respite and skills training program for people experiencing developmental disabilities. We served 48 people in our program last year and provided over 14,000 hours of direct care service to the families and the participants. RAISE is our Refugee Assistance and Immigration Service. This provides resettlement services for refugees. Last year, we served 460 clients in this program, and this year we are on track to resettle 120 refugees and 105 Afghan evacuees. Supportive Family Services is a program that's designed to provide families with holistic support in an effort to end generational poverty and homelessness through education and community support. None of the work that we do would be possible without the generous support of our donors. We want to thank you for the generous support that you've shown us throughout the years and ask for your continued support. To donate, please visit our website at cssalaska.org and click on Donate, which is the button in the upper right-hand corner. Under Special Instructions, add the words Advent Benefit Concert. You can also place a check in the collection basket at St. Patrick's. Again, thank you so much for all of the support that you have provided to CSS.
Each year, Advent invites us to come alive again in the vision of God's plan for us. As children, we had a sense of wonder. Our eyes drank in the fascinating gifts we beheld, and our thirsty souls could not have enough of the wonders of creation. Then, somehow, we grew too old to dream. We became blind to the magnificence of the world and stepped back from life's abundance. But the natural gift of wonder God gave us as children was meant to be lifelong. Advent reminds us to wake up and celebrate the gifts of love we have received. God of wonder and light, create in us a fountain of joy. Stir in us a spirit ready to dance. Kindle in us the fire of gladness, and set loose in us songs of praise. For you are the one who comes with healing and love for all your people. We pray in the name of Christ, for whom we wait with joyful hope. Amen. You are the light that shines in the darkness. Christ, be our light. We watch and wait with wonder and awe.
Oh,
Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord.
Lord, may it be done to me according to your word. Then the angel departed from her.
Traditional choir have a rare opportunity to have one of our members, Evelyn Fink, join us with music and song from Arizona. This is Mary's song.
Thank you.
We quietly reflect on the mystery. We rest in awe, in wonder, at how our God entered our world and came to be with us. We pause to receive the gifts offered us, that the Spirit of God will come anew into our lives, and that Jesus will really find a home in our hearts. We wait in watchful hope, believing in the promises of God. Loving God, help us pause to make room in our hearts for those who need us. We thank you for friends and strangers who have received us when we were lonely, afraid, or tired. May we be ready to receive the love you offer us and have the courage to share that love abundantly. We pray in the name of the one for whom there is no room in the inn. Amen. You are the light that shines in the darkness. Christ, be our light. We wait to welcome you with hospitable hearts.
hard on a cold night in a cold place, unnoticed, unheralded by cold people who turned my mother away. On that night, were you listening? On that night, the least of your brothers was me. Now do you see, do you hear, and do you care? I am not coming soon. I am here. In your life, do you see me in the ragged men and women who search the cold street looking for my reflection in your heart? Do you hear my voice in their muttered plea or in their tear? I am not coming soon. I am here. Do you hear me when your friend turns to you to ask forgiveness and trust? Do I not forgive you always? Do I not give you a merciful ear? I am not coming soon. I am here. In this season, I was born unto you, fulfilling the promise of God's care. Look for me. Listen to me. I am not coming soon. I am here.
Did you know, Mary, gentle and fair?
in us be sown. Fullness of true light, through us be known. Secret held tenderly, guarded with love, cradled in purity, child of the dove, come.
Simple is not usually a compliment, yet one dictionary defines the word as meaning plain, honest, and intelligible. So maybe it's not such a bad thing to be. Nevertheless, somehow we feel suspicious when something seems too simple. Where is the catch, we ask ourselves. It is almost as though we need some elaborate complexities before we can accept it. Jesus understood this human weakness very well. Throughout his life, he used simple illustrations to reveal God's plans. He used the corn, a relaxed meal with friends, fishing, and winemaking so vividly and effectively. Yet the scribes and Pharisees constantly asked, "What's the catch?" each time they encountered him. Simplicity is at the heart of Christ's message. Your heavenly Father loves you as you are. No strings, no catch. Even if we turn away or do not believe this, he still loves us. During the weeks of Advent, we listen to many rousing prophecies about the coming of the Messiah. At the end of this season, we are presented with a little baby. The baby Jesus might appear too simple a solution to the problems of God's people. What's the catch, we might ask? Christ's birth is the celebration of the great Emmanuel, that is, God is with us, mystery. And God is with us so that we may know that we are infinitely lovable. To come as a baby was his first and greatest lesson to us, for it teaches us the most important lessons of all about God's attitude towards us. A child is full of freshness and trusting love. Its eyes are to the future, to growing up. Unspoilt by prejudice or bitterness, each child is a new beginning. A child's loving confidence can make the greatest villain think again, and it can bring new life to the old and weary. But the greatest lesson is one which we have all experienced. When we have stretched out a tentative finger to a new baby, and he or she grasps it with an uncanny strength. Stretch out just one finger to the Lord this Christmas, and he will take strong hold of you for as long as you let him.
Are you among all women born to her?
joining us. I'd also like to thank our pastor, Father Leo Walsh, Deacon Nick Fornelli, and the staff at St. Patrick's, the readers, the soloists and musicians from around Anchorage, and the music ministry here at St. Pat's, an enthusiastic and diverse group. We are blessed to have such talented musicians. It makes my job as music director easy to do. I'd also like to thank my friend Sharon Hickel for our wonderful Advent candle lighting readings and other readings. Thank you for your generous support of Catholic Social Services. To donate to Catholic Social Services, go to their website, cssalaska.org, click the Donate button, and in the Special Instructions field, add Advent Benefit Concert. You can also put a check in the collection basket at St. Patrick's, add Advent Benefit Concert in the notes section. As we wait for the Lord to come again in glory, please join us as we sing, O Come, O Come, Emmanuel.